Hey guys, how's it going? Welcome to Evening Prayer. Well, if you've been keeping up with what's going on up there in Washington, that debacle, clearly, thinking people see what's happening. If you hadn't seen the community post I talked about listening to Rush Limbaugh's show today, I highly recommend you go on his website and listen to that podcast that he'll put the shows from the day up there and listen to it. Mainly because of the callers. But Rush, he sees the same thing. I'm listening to him talk and it's like, yep, that's it. Exactly what we've already said. He sees it. And his callers, people were calling in. Bunch of people were calling in that were there that day. They said it didn't go down anything like they said it did. And they gave their story. One of them was right there and saw the whole thing unfold. It was a put-up deal. They paid Antifa and Black Lives Matter to come in there and to start up trouble for one purpose. Because now all you hear them talk about all the rest of the day today, impeaching Trump. Because they don't want him to run in 2024. Because if they impeach him, he will be ineligible to run. It was all a plan. Now, in my mind, knowing what I know and seeing some of the things that I've seen, and plus some certain revelations that have come out, I highly suspect something's going to happen in the next 13 days. If you go over to Chad at Watchmen on the Wall 88 and watch his videos, Israel started heavily attacking Damascus. If they don't get him out, we could see an airstrike against Iran and Syria and maybe a little bit in Turkey. Who knows? I'll tell you one thing, though. All this is fitting in prophecy so perfectly. And it doesn't cause... I would think, you know, because I used to, when things like this would happen, when I was doing vlogs, I'd get all fired up. I used to feel that way about that. Now I'm not fearful. We're closer. Every time something like this happens, we're closer and closer to when the Lord is going to return. Guys, you wait and watch. Because they've got this big head now. They think that they've won, and they haven't won anything. And they're going to be all on their high horse. They're going to be all up there patting each other on the back. They're going to be all there talking all kinds of smack. And all of a sudden, everything changes. You're going to hear them start saying peace and safety. We're for peace and safety. We're getting rid of Trump, who isn't for peace. I heard that today. And you're going to hear them say it over and over and over again. And then we're gone. And then the whole world changes. Then everything changes. And those that stood against our Lord and Savior will pay. They will have to answer for what they've done. They will suffer the consequences for their decisions and actions. Our Lord has already won. The war has been won a long time ago, 2,000 years ago. Done, finished, that's it. We're just waiting for the fullness of time for it to do everything that needed to be done. And we're right at the end of that time frame. We're witnessing what's happening. Somebody commented, I think it was Rhonda, had commented for this morning that sometimes she just doesn't know what to pray for. I know, I'm that way too. When you don't know what to pray for His will to be done. Sometimes, just pray for His will to be done. And what's amazing is about what we're going to read here is there's a particular verse in here. Or actually, there's a verse from Exodus. I believe it's Exodus 14:14. And it says, "The Lord will fight for you. All you need to do is be still." I think it's Exodus 14:14. Let me look. The picture over here, the picture is not over here. Well, I emailed it to myself. Anyway, let me see. Okay, we won't do it. So Exodus, it's in Exodus, I know that, but it says just be still. The Lord will take care of it. And that's what we need to do. We're going to cover some scriptures in this article here. Living before the throne. I wish that stupid banner was gone. But we're going to close with a very, very powerful series of verses in Romans. And I'm not going to tell you where they're at until right when we get there, because they're going to be amazing. When it feels like the world is against you, I sat in my car with tears streaming down my face and hands gripping the steering wheel. My thoughts were filled with pleading and accusations against the Lord. Where are you, Lord? Everything is falling apart and I don't see you anywhere in this mess. Why aren't you with me? Thankfully, God is unendingly patient with me. Once I had gotten over my mini meltdown, he met me right there in my car with four simple words that changed me. Four words that I still hang on to when trouble comes. I am for you. When he said those words, Bible verses I had read for years came flooding back. Do not be afraid or discouraged, for the Lord will personally go ahead of you. He will be with you. He will neither fail you nor abandon you. Deuteronomy 31:8. For I know the plans I have for you, says the Lord. They are plans for good and not for disaster, to give you a future and a hope. Jeremiah 29:11. Who then will condemn us? No one. For Christ Jesus died for us and was raised to life for us, and he is sitting at the place of honor at God's right hand, pleading for us. Romans 8:34. Yes, God is for me, and he's also for you. Jesus himself is advocating for you right now in heaven. God sent the Holy Spirit to be with us and help us. John 14:16. And this is a quote from, Joe Anderson. Something like that. So when I find myself weary by the troubles of this life, I quickly remind myself that the God of all creation is on my side. My job is not to worry, but to rest in him. Take heart, my friend. When the whole world feels against you, God is still for you. He has not abandoned you. Even if your troubles and sorrows are a result of your own sin, Jesus is still your advocate. 1 John 2:1. There's no other champion I'd rather have. So when I find myself weary by the troubles of this life, I quickly remind myself that the God of all creation is on my side. My job is not to worry, but to rest in him. Here it is. It's Exodus 14:14. The Lord himself will fight for you. Just stay calm. Just be still. Just wait. Now, a lot of people I heard talking today on the radio, I listened to Hannity, listened to Rush, and a couple other people pop in. And it sounds like the wind has been taken out of their sails. A lot of people who stood up for right, who were hoping for the right thing to happen, are disgusted with what's happened. But they sound like this is the end. What they don't realize is this is only the end of one thing. This is only the end of evil's control. See, evil has been in control for thousands of years. We're now at the point where they're about to lose their control. See, the tribulation, people say it's a time where evil will have full control. No, they won't. They won't have any control. They're going to be allowed to do what they want to do, but they will have no control. Because they're going to be suffering wrath. And it's going to be wrath that will be extremely justified. Brought on by a just and truthful God who has been saving this up and holding it back for a long time. The truth of the matter is, no matter what we see happen in our government or any other nation's government, no matter what war we see in another country, no matter how many people step up and say, I have a word from the Lord about this, and start spouting off some stuff that doesn't even match the Bible, no matter what dream, no matter what vision, no matter what evil, no matter what good, no matter nothing that happens on this earth to any of us, or them, God is in control of every single bit of it. Things that happen are only happen because he allows them to happen. Now, some people like to take that as a negative. It's not a negative. He's teaching us. He's showing us things. He's showing us this world is not yours. You don't belong here. You don't have a say in anything that goes on here. I'm taking care of this. What I want you to do is I want you to band together. Stay faithful, follow me, bless each other, edify each other, and strengthen each other, and stay in my word. That's not a word from the Lord, that's from Scripture. He wants us to just let it happen. Like I said, the victory's already been won. They don't know it yet, but they're about to find out, and they're not going to like it very much. But they've made their choice. When somebody's made their choice, you have no choice but to walk away. You have no choice but to say, adios. Okay, you did. This is what you want. Okay. I told you everything I can tell you. We are not to fear. We are not to be troubled. These things that we're seeing on the outside and to your normal, average, everyday person looks horrible. And it looks like there's no hope. When I see these things happen, I find more hope. Because what these things show me is that he's closer and closer and closer. What these things show me is that the time is so near. They can have it. They can have this world. They can have this system that they've created. Because their own system is going to eat them alive. But we will be with the Lord. We won't be here. We won't be here for this. We will be with the Lord, standing with him, worshiping with him, resting, being blessed, being changed. And we won't have to deal with this anymore. We don't have to deal with it now, technically. Let the world go to the world. Let the things of the world go to the things of the world. You rest in Jesus Christ, because you are a child of God. Bought and paid for with a price of precious blood. The highest price of able to be paid. And you don't belong to this world. You belong to him. Let's pray. Lord, we come before you this evening. In a way, in a state of being solemn. But I find more hope in what's happening. Evil is on the rise. It has been for a long time. Evil is rising up. Evil is playing their cards that they have, the last cards they have. Evil is taking over. Evil is doing what it wants to do. And we know that it's supposed to happen that way. We know that it is our Father in heaven that allows these things to happen. We know by these things, the end is near. The time of your arrival is so close. Not only are things going weird in America, but things are going crazy in other places. We see the elements happening pertaining to several prophecies active at this very minute around the world. Lord, we give you glory and praise because of these amazing revelations and opening our eyes to see these truths. We honor you because you paid such an amazing price and saved us, choosing us, who you're going to save, choosing who you're going to die for. You died for everybody. And separating us out from the world. Building up your most holy church. When you build a building, you build it out of rough-hewn timber that's not been tempered. And wood is tempered with pressure and heat. It's not been tempered. It doesn't last very long. Yet when you build it out of rock, brick, stuff that's been fired through a kiln, tempered lumber, that building lasts a long time. And that tempering process is what we're going through here. And you don't want us attached to this world. Lord, help us to break our ties with this world. Help us to break our connections with all the things we can. To not rely on this world and not have any wants in this world. Help us to desire you in everything we do. And when we see travesties happening on our Capitol steps, when we see evil in open daylight doing what they're doing and not even hiding their agenda, when we see the good exhaling in exhaustion and giving up, we know that's when you apply your strongest action. And all we have to do is, like Exodus 14:14 says, wait, stay calm, watch. Lord, we're watching. We're watching for you. We're waiting for you. We know that our time to be removed is coming very, very near. We know there are things that are going to happen. We trust you. Because we know that everything that happens here is temporary. It's what's on the other side that's eternal. Me personally, I'm looking for the things on the other side. Lord, thank you for your word and these revelations, and thank you for choosing us to be alive at this time to see what we're seeing, to have faith now in a world that teaches everyone from birth to not have faith. That takes everything that is good that you have given us and turns it into something so evil, merely for money, merely for fame. But they don't realize what they're doing. They don't know that there is an all-powerful God watching. They don't know that there's wrath building and vengeance will be taken on those who have chosen the wrong path. Lord, I thank you that we have made the right choice, that you chose us and you drew us in. I thank you that we are sheep in your herd, that we are in your pasture. Help us to strengthen each other and to embolden each other, and help us to stand in the day when evil comes for us. And help us to always be ready and always be watching and always be looking. You've given us enough signs. How can we not know? But amazingly enough, there are people who don't know. Well, we know. We're watching. We're waiting. We're listening for that call. We're listening for that trumpet. We're waiting for the moment when everything changes. Because then we can leave this world behind. The pain, the suffering, the troubles, we can leave it behind. And we can come and we can stand in your presence. We can be in your house. We can be changed to be like you. And after 7 years, we come back with you and we get to watch you take your kingdom back. What a glorious day. It's a terrible day for those who are on the earth, and we don't pray for anyone to be there that day. We want people to get saved, and hopefully the vast majority will turn. But the glory of that day isn't the destruction. The glory of that day isn't the death and suffering. The glory of that day is you taking back your kingdom, becoming the rightful ruler, becoming the rightful king, sitting on your throne. And all these people that are in power now, all these people that seek their own agenda, won't have power anymore. Then we know right and truth will be done, and we're waiting for that day. Thank you, Lord, for the amazing blessings you pour out upon us. Thank you for this amazing grace. Thank you for this amazing love you show us. Put these things in our hearts that we may show them and shed them on those around us, that we may pour ourselves out as a drink offering to those around us. Count them more significant than we are. Give of ourselves till we have nothing left to give, knowing that in loving them, we're loving you. Help us to not fear. Take the fear away. Help us to not give up. Take the give up away. And help us to be strong and to glorify you no matter what happens. In every instance, in every opportunity, to glorify you and to pronounce the name of Jesus Christ open in front of men. Because that is the name that saves. That is the name above all names. Yours is the name everyone will speak when you are sitting on your throne in Jerusalem. We love you, Lord. We thank you, and we're watching for you. We're waiting for you. Come quickly. This world is definitely not going in any good direction. It is in your name, Lord, that we pray, your precious, precious name that we pray. Amen. Thank you guys for joining me for evening prayer. I would like to take you to Romans 8:31. And I want to read a few verses here. Romans 8:31. What then shall we say to these things? If God is for us, who can be against us? He who did not spare his own son, but delivered him up for us all, how shall he not with him also freely give us all things? Who shall bring a charge against God's elect? It is God who justifies. Who is he who condemns? It is Christ who died, and furthermore is also risen, who is even at the right hand of God, who also makes intercession for us. Who shall separate us from the love of Christ? Shall tribulation, distress, persecution, famine, nakedness, peril, sword? As it is written, for your sake we are killed all day long. We are counted as sheep for the slaughter. Yet in all these things, we are more than conquerors through him who loved us. And I'm going to pause right there for a minute. There's a few more I want to read. I'm going to pause. Guys, do you hear what this is saying? This is speaking to us about what happened and what's happening right now. These things don't touch us. See, we're not our flesh form. The flesh body you see in the mirror, that's not you. The real you is deep down on the inside. It is a spiritual entity. The real you has a brand new body waiting. This body may have all kinds of things happen to it, but you are different. You, that inner person, and the scriptures clearly define this, the inner person, you have already been glorified. You are already seated at the right hand of the Lord. You're already seated in heaven. We're just waiting for the fullness of time for it to be completed. There is a day of redemption coming. And there is nothing that happens on this earth. There is nothing they can do or say or anything. There is no amount of suffering we can endure that will separate us from God. He is faithful even when we aren't. So what does this tell us? When that moment hits us and we're standing there in the gauntlet and we're like, ooh, we remember. No matter what happens to me here, it's irrelevant. I should be happy they're going to put me down. I should be happy because the Lord deemed me worthy to go through these things just like he did. There's a reward for those things. There's a glory that comes from those things. And the Lord has showered his grace upon us in these things. Let's finish reading. Verse 38, for I am persuaded that neither death nor life, nor angels, nor principalities, nor powers, nor things present, nor things to come, nor height, nor depth, nor any other created thing shall be able to separate us from the love of God, which is in Christ Jesus our Lord. See, this is eternal security. And all these people out here who are going on about, oh, yeah, if you did this, you messed up. You don't have your salvation anymore if you did that. And they're all children. They're all speaking from a carnal standpoint. None of them have any understanding. They're not reading their scriptures. They're letting people tell them what it means. And they're giving them money to deceive them. They're paying people to deceive them. And what they don't know is God is more powerful than anything. God is more powerful than the sum of all of his creation. That's not just earth and us. That's everything he's created. Our universe is expansive, and it is a material universe. God has poured his love and imagination and his creativity into everything, and eventually we're going to get to see it all. See, we don't know what all he has laid up for us. The Bible tells us we can't even imagine it, what he has in store for us, what's waiting for us on the other side. What happens here, this is nothing. We're just ticking minutes off the clock waiting for that time when we get to leave. If you're in fear, if you're worried about what's going on, don't be. Is there a possibility, let me be very upfront and honest with everyone. Is there a possibility they get in power, they impeach Trump, they lock all this down, because there won't be any more elections after this, I guarantee that. Could it be that they may decide to put all Christians, all people that went against them, in jail? Absolutely. Could it be that, like Ty Green did a video talking about the detention camps, that we could be all rounded up? Absolutely. Could it be that we could be tortured, renounce your faith? Could it be that we are put to death? Absolutely. And worse than that can happen. See, in my perspective, death is a kindness. They're letting me go so I can go be with the Lord. Paul, he's like, I'd rather die than be here. I love the Lord that much. See, all those things could happen. It's a possibility. Now, if we know those things could happen, if Christ himself told us these things could happen, because we take everything in the Bible to heart, we take it literally. If it says something, but this only, historically it only applies to Jews, we listen to it and we pay attention to it because it's something that could happen to us. Do we fear? No. Do we stumble? No. Do we fall? No. We have faith. We trust because we already know. And we know all we have to do is endure to the end. Now, if we stumble, what happens? If we fall, what happens? He is more faithful and he lifts us up and protects us because he knows how we are. He knows each one of us so personally and in depth that he knows us better than we do. And he's there ready to lift you up. Stay in this word. Stay in this word because everything you need to help you get through what's happening and what's worse that may be coming is in this word. Memorize this word as best you can. Read it and put it on your heart. Love it. Cherish it. And the Holy Spirit will remind you of these things. And you won't have fear anymore. You'll have peace. I know I'm going to heaven. And I don't care how I get there. Be it death from old age, from this disease I have, be it crucifixion, be it burning, be it torture, be it head chopped off, be it rapture. The vehicle I take to get there is irrelevant to me. I just want to go. I just want to go be with the Lord. My desire is solely fixed on just standing next to him. Crowns and riches, that's great, but I just want to stand on his right hand, surrounded by my brothers and sisters who have the same desire. I just want to stand with the Lord and watch him. I just want to stand with him and just feel that incredible, powerful, all-encompassing love that permeates every cell of your body, that emanates through all of heaven. I want to hear the voices of the angels singing. I want to hear the thunder coming out from God's throne. I want to see the emerald road and the sea of glass mingled with fire. See, I can't see those things in this body. This body can't take it. These eyes can't witness those things. But I have to be with him in order to see him. We have a glorious day coming. And the only thing we have to do is stand and wait. The only thing we have to do is have faith. Trust in him. Rely on him. Lean on him. Guys, I'm going to be on the road this weekend. I may not be doing any videos. I'm going to try to post scripture on the community tab if I can. I don't know what's going to happen in the next couple of days. That morning that I told you about that's coming, that morning where we wake up and everything changes, may happen while I'm gone. They may lock the country down. Martial law. I might not be able to cross state lines. I don't know, but I've prepared myself for whatever may happen. I know what I can do and what will need to be done. I know that no matter where I am or what I'm doing, my God is with me, watching over me, taking care of me, and he will not let me fall. He will not let me stumble. He will not let me give up. I trust him for all things. I rely on him for all things. And you should too. Pray to him. Tell him how you feel about these things. If they're bothering you, tell him how you feel. He will comfort you. Believe these scriptures. Trust these scriptures. Know that what he tells you in these things are true. Because knowing those things brings great peace. I love you all very much. I hope Jesus blesses you so much more than he's blessed me. Because if this is what he's done for me and poured this out on me, if he pours it out double on you, you guys will be floating off the ground because I feel amazing with what he's given me. People want to rail, let them rail. People want to accuse, let them accuse. If they want to mock and scoff, let them. Let them accuse. Let them attack. It's irrelevant. Because no matter what they say, no matter what they do, I still believe in Jesus Christ. And he still is on my side. And nothing that happens will change that. Nothing they do, nothing the world does, nothing I do will change that. He is still for me. Because I belong to him, and he will come and get what's his and take it home with him. I bless you guys. I pray Jesus blesses you. I love you guys, and I pray that God's love more and more on you guys. I hope you have a great weekend. I hope I can get to put a video or two out this weekend. I don't know how things are going to go. It's probably going to be pretty hectic, but when something bad happens, turn to the Lord. Let him know you're watching him. Lord, I'm not even going to look at this. I'm going to watch you. And trust him. If he told us all these things were going to happen, we should not be surprised. I hope you guys have a great evening. I love you all dearly, and I will see you guys in the next video.